from Knight of Mary, Soldier of Jesus, serving the sick, the poor, opening schools and colleges, to wreaking havoc in multiple countries, such as influence in civil war in China and Germany, genocide in Bohemia, and attempted coup in England. It's hard to believe these actions came from the same group. The Society of Jesus, also known as the Jesuits. According to them, they are a group of people that seek to find God in all things, dedicated themselves to the greater glory of God and the good of all humanity. Founded in 1534, Saint Ignatius of Loyola and six of his friends started the Society of Jesus in the University of Paris to take vows of poverty, chastity, and pilgrimage to Jerusalem. As the last vow was not possible, they vowed to accept whatever mission the Pope requires. Different from the other orders in the Roman Catholic Church, which stayed in the monastery, the Jesuits would travel to different countries in order to spread their belief. And amongst the countries they went was the sleeping giant in China. Astronomy in China is similar yet different to astronomy in the West. A major purpose of Chinese astronomy, similar to any part of the world, is timekeeping. Chinese astronomers would use their astronomical observations to create and maintain calendars. However, different to the Western astronomers, the Chinese utilized cycles of the moon to create a calendar, hence lunar calendar. Another difference between Chinese and Western calendars is their focus on the stars. While both focus on celestial movement and celestial phenomena, Western astronomy was about how celestial phenomena impact terrestrial phenomena, a one-way relationship. On the other hand, the Chinese had extra focus on eclipses and extra focus on guest stars, or in modern astronomical terms, supernovae and comets. Chinese astronomy was about how terrestrial occurrences are reflected in the heavens and how celestial phenomena can indicate or foretell events on Earth, a two-way relationship. Astronomers would translate the thoughts of heaven to the Son of Heaven, or astronomical observations to the Emperor. Throughout history, astronomical events in different parts of the world have different peaks and valleys. At the time when the Jesuits arrived, Chinese astronomy was in its valley. Around the 16th century, when the Jesuits first arrived in China, was the dynasty of Ming. Traditionally, changing to a new dynasty required changing a new calendar. However, at the start of the Ming Dynasty, the emperor did not want to make any new calendar. Instead, the Ming Dynasty used the calendar from previous dynasties and made amendments to it. Starting from 1367, after years of usage, the calendar became increasingly inaccurate. Until 1385, the Ming Dynasty did not construct any observatory. The emperor only decided to build one, because previous dynasties have done so, and it was built in Nanjing, the capital of the Ming Dynasty. Later in the early 15th century, the capital of the Ming Dynasty was changed to Beijing. Although an observatory was built in Beijing, the astronomical devices were direct copies from Nanjing. Obviously, the latitude-specific devices were not accurate, and adjustments had to be made. But it took almost 90 years, all the way to the early 16th century, to finally finish calibration. From this brief history, we can see that the Ming Dynasty did not attach great importance to astronomy, and the records of astronomy were chaotic.
In the early 16th century, the Portuguese explorers entered the Southern Sea of China, where they encountered a culture that was even older than European civilization. By the late 16th century, Chinese science was far behind European science. When, in 1601, the Jesuits arrived with their missionary purpose, educating people with Christianity. Their stories were quite mysterious and not very well studied in the Chinese history curriculum. However, the Jesuits were the few foreigners whose names appeared in Chinese history. They were regarded as the messengers that brought China to connect with the world. An Italian Jesuit, Matteo Ricci, or Li Fengdou, was one of the first Jesuits that successfully arrived in China. He was regarded as the pioneer of Chinese Catholicism. He was a guy that respected Chinese culture. He spoke Chinese to his followers, and he also wore the traditional Chinese scholar costumes, which gained the favor of the emperor and maintained a good reputation in China during that time. His missionary method was to incorporate Christianity into Chinese tradition and avoid teaching the part where it contradicts with Chinese Confucianism, such as the part of Jesus that was nailed to the cross. He also learned to please the Chinese scholars with his novel things, such as the hardcover Bible and the prism. He also created 万国全图, or a map of the myriad countries of the world, and placed China at the center of the map, which again pleased the Chinese people. This was also the first world map that appeared in China, and was duplicated many times during that time. Many people heard about these stories and came to visit him. People during that time referred to him as an eminent mathematician and astronomer. His major contribution to Chinese astronomy was the introduction of Euclid's Elements of Geometry. He translated Euclid's work to Chinese, which hugely influenced the method of investigation of China and turned the way of development of Chinese mathematics. Moreover, he brought China the modern astronomical tables, which was a significant improvement of the ones that China used during that time. Another important Jesuit that came after Matteo Ricci was Adam Shaw, or Tang Ruo Wang. In 1634, he helped Chinese astronomer Xu Guangqi to finish the huge volume of Chongzhen Li Shu, or the Chongzhen Calendar. This book introduced Western astronomy thoroughly. There were 46 volumes in this book, containing very comprehensive information about astronomy. It includes the method to deduct the position of the sun, the planets, and the moon, the prediction of eclipses, as well as the motion of the five planets and their relative motion. There are five subjects that were concerned, including Fa Yuan, the theories about astronomical calendar, Fa Shu, astronomical mathematics, Fa Suan, the mathematics that is used in prediction of the astronomical calendar, Fa Qi, the astronomical instruments, and Hui Tong, the conversion table of the Chinese and Western units. This book systematically introduced the Western astronomical progress and made Chinese people realize that they were far behind the West, making them start learning and incorporating Western astronomy. This book also introduced Ptolemy's system, Tycho's system, and Copernicus' system. However, it regards Tycho's geoheliocentrism as the truth. This work marked that Chinese astronomy was finally in confluence with the world. In 1645, he condensed the Chongzhen calendar and renamed it to Western New Calendar, and the Qing Emperor renamed it to Constitutional Calendar. This laid the foundation for the calendar making for each year and was the basis of the Chinese lunar calendar in the modern era. Adam Shaw was then made the director of the Imperial Astronomical Bureau. He was the first foreigner in this position. One of Adam Shaw's successors in the Imperial Astronomical Bureau was Ferdinand Verbiest, or Nan Huairen, a Belgian Jesuit. He arrived to China in 1658 and helped Adam Shaw with his calendar work. However, he was sent to jail due to condemned heresy. He was released on bail in 1668 and made the director of the Imperial Astronomical Bureau to create astronomical instruments for the observatory. He designed and supervised the manufacture of the ecliptic armillary sphere, the equatorial armillary sphere, and the altazimuth, and other instruments to use in correspondence with the Western astronomy. He also published more than 20 books on astronomy using Chinese, including a book on the use of telescopes. He became the science teacher of the Kangxi Emperor, responsible for teaching geometry and astronomy to the emperor, and making astronomical observations for him. Kangxi Emperor then developed interests in natural science and a respectful attitude to European Jesuits. This made him more open-minded towards Western knowledge and culture, which pushed China further into the connection with Western development. In 1773, under the suppression of the Society of Jesus, the Jesuits left China. They returned in 1814 after the Reformation and founded observatories in China. In 1950, their control was seized by the communist government, which marked the end of the story. In summary, the Jesuits brought both material contributions and a change of attitude to China. They introduced the Western theories of astronomy, making China in confluence with Western science. During their stay, they not only created new astronomical instruments, but also made further discoveries and published them in Chinese. All these are advancing Chinese astronomy, which were in a stagnation during that time. Despite the resistance to new astronomical concepts which existed in the Chinese culture at that time, the Jesuits were observed to overcome obstacle after obstacle, persisting on their way to transmit scientific concepts to those in power in the Chinese Empire, as it gradually became clear to them that only by conveying extensive knowledge to these authority figures, such as the emperor, could they truly succeed in preaching their views. Therefore, it is generally considered that the Jesuits had an overall long-lasting positive effect on the Chinese astronomical culture, regardless of the various difficulties they had encountered. Chinese scholars and astronomers were educated to a great extent by the Jesuits, who broadened their horizons in various areas in science, assisting them in the prediction of eclipses, examining the positions and movements of celestial bodies, as well as developing new astronomical instruments. They transmitted knowledge that carried the history of Western astronomy from ancient times to the Greeks and Ptolemy, from the Middle Ages to Copernicus, Brahe, and Kepler, and from Galileo and the telescope to Newton and the Royal Society, visibly strengthened the Chinese understanding of the universe and celestial bodies. Despite the myriad of positive effects that the Jesuits brought to the Chinese culture, it also illustrates some negative influences. The situation for the Jesuits quickly spiraled down to a tough predicament at the start of the 18th century, when the rites controversy triggered chaotic conflicts between the religions and beliefs of the newly arrived Jesuits and the local Chinese culture. The controversy was sparked by mendicant missionaries, Franciscan and Dominican, who rejected certain essential elements and rituals in Chinese tradition beliefs, such as worshipping at ancestral altars, which was a ritual practice in the Confucian tradition. This was mainly due to the Jesuits' belief that the only way to achieve a wider range of the spread of scientific knowledge, especially astronomical knowledge, is to be pragmatic. As a result, many Chinese people began to believe that the Jesuits' transmission of knowledge was an attack on Chinese claims to moral superiority and an assault on Chinese self-esteem. The benefits brought by the missionaries to Chinese astronomical society gradually dwindled as governors of the Chinese Empire commenced the expulsion of Jesuits from the local culture. An example of this would be Yongzheng, Emperor of Qing Dynasty, who began to expel all Catholic missionaries since 1723, except those working for the court. The Jesuits, many of whom were not used to severe persecution, quickly retreated out of the Chinese community, with only a few operating in secret. Despite the endeavors to preach Western astronomical knowledge to all the societal pillars of the Chinese society, the Jesuits' influence in Chinese astronomy was still only confined to a small circle of Chinese scholars and elites, as the hierarchy in the local culture made it extremely difficult to make the relevant knowledge prevalent. Furthermore, as heliocentric views on the solar system were banned by the Catholic Church in 1616, in Western cultures during that time, The Jesuits in China are often accused of holding back the process of the Chinese astronomical development by forcing the outdated Ptolemaic concepts on the Chinese society, which was later proven false.